In the previous tutorial, we have learned how to create sofa and bed. In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to create dynamic block of dining table. If you are interested in previous set of tutorials, complete playlist is given in the description. At first, I will show you what is dynamic block. I will insert one block. I have already created dynamic block of dining table. I will click on it and click here. So your block is inserted. When you click on these dynamic blocks, it will show you the grips which you can use to modify its configuration. Suppose if I click on this arrow and take cursor on the right side, you can see that number of chairs are also increasing automatically. Same way on this side. If I take cursor on this side, it is increasing the number of chairs on this side also. Such type of blocks are called dynamic blocks. To create block, click here on block editor. If you cannot find this command, you can also type BEdit for block editor. Click on it. Then give the name to your block. Suppose I will name it as dining table. Then click on OK. It will switch you to this gray background block editor, where it is showing this block authoring palettes. You can turn on and off these palettes by clicking on this authoring palettes. If you click here, you can turn it off. And again, if you click on it, you can turn it on. Then to shift this XY icon, I will just type UCS icon, enter, no origin. So it will shift that UCS icon. So in this, at first we will create the object. For that, you will have to click on this home tab, then click on rectangle, then for first point specify 0, 0, enter. Then for other corner specify 800, 800, enter, zoom minus. Then we will create one more square for chairs. Click on rectangle, specify first point, then give the size of 400, 400, enter. Then we want to offset this line. Now this is a polyline. So what we will do, we will explode it. Click on explode. Select this square, enter. Then click on offset. Then press enter. Then click on this line. Take your cursor on this side and click. Then enter. Then I want to align this chair at the middle of this vertical line. For that, click on move. Select this object, enter, then click on this midpoint for base point. Then take your cursor to this midpoint, don't click there, track that point, take it away, just zoom it, again track it and click and zoom minus. Then we will array this chair. For that, click here and select polar array. Then select this chair, enter, then specify the center point of array. Center point of array will be center of this square. To locate the center, take your cursor to midpoint, don't click there. Again, take your cursor to this midpoint, don't click there, and take your cursor in the center and click. Then for number of atoms, specify 4, press enter and press escape. So here array is created. Then this array is a single entity. We don't want it to be single entity. For that, we will again explode this array. Click on explode, select this array, enter. Now these are separate entities. Then in dynamic blocks, at first you will have to specify the parameters. Click on parameters. We want to change the length of this table. Therefore, we will apply this linear parameters. Click on it, zoom minus, then specify start point and specify end point. Take your cursor above and click. The meaning of this yellow exclamatory sign is that you have not applied any actions. So here we can directly double click on this yellow box to apply the action, or you can also choose action by clicking on this action and choosing your required action. Now, as we change the length of this table, we want to increase number of chairs. That means we will have to array these chairs. To apply the action of array, just double click on this yellow square, select parameters. So I want to apply the action to this distance parameter, so click on this distance, then click on array, then for array you will have to select object. So I will choose these two chairs, then press enter. Then you will have to specify the distance between columns. So my distance between columns will be 800. Then press enter. So here you can see that action of array is applied. And that yellow square of exclamatory sign is also removed. Now we can test this block. For that, click on this block editor and click on test block. Then click on this block, click on this arrow and take your cursor on the right side. Here you can observe that as we take our cursor on the right side, number of chairs are increasing. Same way, if you click on this arrow and take our cursor on the left side, on left side also number of chairs are increasing. Now chairs are increasing, but the size of table is not changing. So to change the size of the table, we will have to apply one more action. To go back to block editor, click here on close and click on close test block. Then next is to apply the stretch action to change the size of the table. For that, click on stretch in the action section. Stretch. Then select parameter, again click on distance. Then specify parameter point. So at first I will choose this point. Then specify first corner of stretch frame. So I will give first corner at this position. Click there and take your cursor on the left side and click. Then you will have to select the object, and for that I will repeat the same procedure. Click here, take your cursor on the left side and click. Then press enter. Now here the stretch action is applied. Again, to test this block, click here on test block, then click on this block. Now click here and take your cursor on this side. Now here you can watch that the number of chairs as well as the size of table is also changing. And if we click here, now here the length of table is not changing. So again we will have to apply stretch action to this arrow. For that, again take your cursor here and click on close test block. Again we will have to repeat the same procedure. Click on stretch, then select this distance parameter, then click on this point, then specify first corner of stretch frame. I will click here, take it on the left side and click. Then select object, again click on the right side, because we need to use crossing window and not this blue window. Therefore always click on the right side and take your cursor on the left side and click. Then press enter. Now here second stretch action is applied. Again to test this block, click on test block, click on this block and click on this arrow. Now here also it is changing the size of the table, and here also it is changing the size of the table. But if you observe here, actually here it is not changing it proportionately. So to change it proportionately, we will have to make some settings. For that, at first, close this test block. Then to make the setting for proportionate increment, type PR. For properties, press enter. Now here is the properties window. Click on distance, then scroll it down and go to this value set. Distance type, click on none, then click on increment. Then distance increment, here we will specify the width of table, that is 800, press enter. Then close this dialog box, then escape. Then again we can test this block, click on test block, click on this block, click on this arrow. So here you can observe that it is showing lines at the distance of 800 and it is incrementing it proportionately. Same way on this side also, it is doing the same. Click here and close it. Now this block is perfectly ready. Then here you will have to save block. Click on save block. Then click on close block editor. Then to use this block, click here on insert and click on this block and give the position. Then click and here you can change the size of the block. Press escape. Now this block can be used in the same drawing. If you want to use this block in any other drawing, then for that we will have to convert this block into W block. For W block, type W, enter, then click on block, then click here and choose this dining table. Then here you can change the folder location by clicking on this three dot, or you can accept the default location. Then here you can choose your unit in which you have created that block. So I have created in millimeter, so I will keep this millimeter as it is. Click on OK. Now this block is converted into W block. Suppose now I will start new drawing. Then to insert that block, click here and click on block from other drawings. Then click on this to display the file selection dialog box. Then choose our block, dining table, this one, open. Then right click on this block and insert and click and close this dialog box. In this way you can insert the block in other drawing. So that's all. In the next lecture we will learn next set of commands and we will solve exercises based on those commands, and we will also continue our lectures for civil and electrical. So thanks for watching. We will stop here.